Hi students, today I am discussing about epimerization, or also known as isomerization, also known as enolization, another name tautomerization. This reaction carried out in diluted base, this transformation from one form to another form, for example D glucose to D mannose or D glucose to this is fructose D fructose or D fructose to D glucose, D fructose to D mannose to D fructose. So these are interconvertible in basic medium. This is called Loubry De Bruijn van Ekenstein transformation. This is a D glucose open chain structure in basic medium. This OH minus will take this hydrogen and it will be transmuted like this. Then here this carbon will get negative charge. Negative charge is represented with this lone pair, next negative charge. So now this negative charge will be shifted to here and this will be shifted to towards more electronegative oxygen atom. That's why it will be get the negative charge and it is double bond. Already one bond is there, next it will come in double bond. Then this is resonance between these two structures. This is resonance symbol. These are equilibrium symbol. Carefully you have to observe this equilibrium, this is resonance. And this is called en ion, this is negative charge 8, that's what is called enolate ion. This is when this H2O, I can write like this also, OHOH. Then this negative charge will be moved, this negative charge will be moved like this. Then this negative charge will take this hydrogen atom. Then hydrogen may be left side or right side. Now we are going to transform into the D mannose. Already hydrogen it is abstracted from the left side, then it will go now right side because it is planar structure. Then it may convert toward the left or right side. Now it may be right side. That's why now observe D glucose and D mannose in these two. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 3, 4, 5, 6 configurations are remain same. Only configuration change at the second position. That's why this is called C2 epimers. At second position of carbon, configuration is different. Then it is called C2 epimers. This is a 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Second position configuration different. That's why it is called C2 epimers. Now, this enolate ion may convert into this enediol. This is called enediol. Double bond is an en and ol is there. That is called 2 hydroxy is there. That's why enediol. Now, these two hydroxy groups are same. That's why it may call Z form. It may be left side also. That thing is called Z. It may be exist in any one of the form. If the competitive exam, they may ask the question. Glucose in dilute basic medium, it convert into enediol is intermediate in transformation of fructose. Then that enediol may be exist in the E, option A, option B, Z, option C, E and Z, and D cannot be predicted. Like this question may be given in, it can be exist in the any one of the form. E and Z form also it can exist. Generally we are written like this in the Z form. It means similar groups of same size, that is cis type. Cis type means Z, zeuxo means, and this is N-type again mean opposite groups, that may be any one. Okay. So now I am transforming into the D fructose form. In the D fructose form, actually how it is converted from enolate, that also we will discuss. This negative charge will take proton from this water molecule. For example, like this water molecule will be there. So this hydrogen will take by this oxygen, then here we will get OH. Then we will get which one? OH minus side also, it is present. So now we are converting into keto form. Now this hydrogen I am writing separate. Here bond. This is called tautomerization. This double bond will be shifted here. This will be shifting here. Then you will get negative charge, this positive charge. Both will convert into form bond. Then it is already H is there here. And this H. Then total CH2, 1, 2 and here this. Hydrogen and this hydrogen. H2, carbon and OH. This is C double bond will group convert. C and already bond is this bond will convert to C double bond. Remaining downward as it is, that is same. This D fructose. That's why I am writing here D glucose is interconverting to D mannose. Next it is interconvert into, or like this we can write. D fructose. Therefore, in the last class somewhere we discussed fructose also will give tolerance and failing test. Reason, in basic medium this keto group will convert into through this transition. These are all in equilibrium form. So it is backward action also will occur to convert to D glucose or D mannose. So therefore, what is the reason why fructose will give tolerance and failing test? The reason is this epimerization or tautomerization or isomerization, enolization. They may ask the question in NEET level or JEE Mains level. What is the reason of fructose will give tolerance and failing test? Sometime in option may be enolization, sometime may be option in the epimerization, any one of the option is there. Then generally the preferable answer is enolization, because this in basic medium this is through enolization it is converting into the fructose to glucose. That's why it will be gives tolerance and failing test, and the reaction name is known as, in the rare case sometimes they are asking this question, this conversion of glucose to mannose or glucose to fructose, what is the reaction name? Loebright, De Bruijn, Van Eckenstein transformation or reaction. Thank you very much.